This is a pretty typical view during the summer across fields in the Corn Belt of the U.S. But this is a not-so-typical view. From ground level, we can see the neat, orderly rows of corn separated by soil that's pretty much completely free of weeds. How is that? Well, many large-scale corn growers in the U.S. take a little help from an herbicide called atrazine to get these weed-free fields. Atrazine is one of the most common herbicides used in agriculture in the U.S. An herbicide is a chemical that is toxic to plants and is used to prevent or slow growth. Every year, atrazine is applied to over 50 million acres of agricultural land, mostly cornfields in the Midwestern U.S. This amounts to about 70 million pounds of atrazine. It doesn't kill the corn, but it does kill lots of the common weeds you would find growing in cornfields. Let's take a look at what happens to a plant that's susceptible to the killing effects of atrazine. We can set up a little experiment using wild clover, a common plant that might be growing in cornfields. If we treat the plant with a commercial herbicide containing atrazine, the results are pretty dramatic. We went from healthy and green to shriveled and brown. So what is the atrazine doing to the plant? Why is the plant struggling to survive? Let's compare a healthy plant and a plant treated with atrazine. We pretty much see all the normal pieces and parts, so it must be doing something at a cellular or subcellular level, something we just can't see. Let's zoom in a little bit. If we take a look at a leaf from a healthy and a sick plant, and we look even closer to see cells in those leaves, and now we look even closer at those cells, that little thing right there is a chloroplast. That is atrazine's target. It's poisoning something in that chloroplast. Now, you probably already know that the chloroplast is a site of photosynthesis, but we need to dig in a little deeper. Let's visualize what's happening during photosynthesis in a healthy chloroplast. Here we have the major components involved in photosynthesis, two photosystems that absorb light energy from the sun using chlorophyll, an electron transport chain, and an ATP synthase. Photosystem 2 has this enzyme that can strip electrons away from water, leaving behind waste oxygen. Those electrons are energized by light and passed on to the electron transport chain. The electron transport chain passes the electrons on to photosystem 1, where they are re-energized by light and passed on to the electron carrier NADPH. So those electrons that started on water have now ended up being carried by NADPH. Now, as the electron transport chain is passing electrons, it's also moving protons around. The ATP synthase exploits that buildup of protons to make ATP, the energy carrier molecule in the cell. Now we can use carbon dioxide from the air, along with the ATP and NADPH, to fuel the Calvin cycle. This cycle uses the energy from ATP to transfer the electrons from NADPH to carbon dioxide, building the molecule glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or G3P. That's used as a building block for sugars that will be used by the plant for energy and growth, basically keeping it alive. So what happens with the atrazine? Let's focus on this part of the pathway. Atrazine works by stealing the electrons from photosystem 2. That means photosystem 2 has no electrons to send to the electron transport chain, no electrons reach photosystem 1, and no electrons are available to get passed on to produce NADPH. If no electrons are being passed along the electron transport chain, then no protons are getting moved around. Without the buildup of protons, the ATP synthase just isn't able to make ATP. So if we can't make sufficient NADPH or ATP, then we don't have the electrons or the energy needed by the Calvin cycle to make the sugar that's needed for the plant to survive. So that's how atrazine poisons plants, by targeting the chloroplast and stopping photosynthesis. By poisoning that first piece in the pathway, the whole system shuts down. And that's the premise for how most herbicides work, by targeting the critical components in photosynthesis to shut it down and kill the plant.